Now it's time for Bette Davis and two imposters to challenge our panel. Now, let me show you the setup. Wow. In front of me, you see an opaque curtain. It runs right straight down the middle of our stage here. It prevents our panel from seeing the other side where Miss Davis and her two imposters are seated. Now, panel, there's one other thing that you ought to know. The two imposters are not only imposters, but also talented mimics. They will attempt to sound as much as possible like Bette Davis. It'll be your job to determine whether number one, number two, or number three is the real Bette Davis. And we start the questioning with Kitty Carlisle.
Oh, thank you, Bud. That's fine. Now, you look like a tennis sub.
I feel like one.
Number one, you played when you were very young with a famous English actor. Can you give me his name?
Leslie Howard.
All right.
I just like it.
Number two, you used to have wonderful clam bakes in Hollywood, and you invited my husband and me to a clam bake. Where did you get the lobsters from?
From Maine.
Thank you. Number three, who wrote The Night of the Iguana?
I'm sorry.
Tennessee Williams.
All right. Tom Poster.
Oh, that's so funny. How do you know? All right, number three, if Tennessee Williams wrote Night of the Iguana, who was your leading man?
Patrick O'Neill.
Gosh, listen to those voices.
Wow.
Number two, who played with you in Three on a Match?
That was too long ago for me to remember.
Oh, I just happened to see it the other night on television. Number one, what is that thing about the letter? When people do impressions of you, what is that letter that they are always talking about?
They're always naming a man named Peter. And he was never in the letter.
Number one. Yes.
Peggy Cass.
Number three, you have a son who's very handsome and whom I like very much. What is his name?
Michael.
Thank you. And number one, where does he go to school? Number two.
Would you repeat the question, please?
Yes, where does he go to school?
It's none of your business.
Yes, go ahead.
Number two, where in Boston are you from?
Lowell, Massachusetts.
Orson Bean.
Who'd you ask to? Number three, in what picture did you say, what a dump? You came into a room and you say, what a dump.
Beyond the Forest.
Ah. Number two, do you know who George Kirby is? Number two?
I haven't the vaguest notion.
Oh, I figured he's a mimic. I figured if you were a mimic. Number one. Mercy.
That's all the time we have. Mark your ballots, panel. Mark them at once without change, without any consultation whatsoever. Vote now. And vote for number one, number two, or number three. Ballots all marked.
Oh, it's impossible.
Can't. Mark it, Kitty.
Oh.
That's the girl. Mark it. All right. They are all marked now. So, Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number three. It's very difficult to keep numbers and voices and answers straight, but I think, if I recall, number three had the best answers for me, Patrick O'Neill and Tennessee Williams. And I voted for her.
Peggy Cass.
She's the only one that really sounded like Bette Davis to me. Number three, and she does have a son named Michael. Fine boy.
Orson.
Number one sounded much more like Bette Davis than Bette Davis does even. So I figured maybe it was Bette Davis trying to sound like somebody imitating Bette Davis, and I voted for her.
Yeah.
Sure you did.
And Kitty Carla.
Well, I can't remember terribly well either, the voices and I think all three of them were remarkable, but if number three said that the clams for the lobsters for the clam bake came from Maine, that was Bette Davis, because they did.
Right, there we have it.
All lobsters come from me.
No!
So the votes are all in and the minds are made up. Now, let's see which of these three ladies in truth is Bette Davis. So as I drop this curtain, will the real Bette Davis please stand up?
She said plans for May. I didn't. Number two said.
Well, it was a great joy. Of course, I don't have to explain to our panel, but maybe to you watching, although you probably know too, that our two wonderful imposters are Miss Kaye Ballard and Miss Patricia Bright.
Thank you.
Go on.
Was none of your business.
I think that's the only thing we didn't review.
It is the Loomis School,
yes,
in Windsor, Connecticut.
Oh, let's not tell. Let's not tell.
Yes, but pull the curtain up and do it again.
May I say something? How
Please.
Can anyone in the world really not recognize Betty Davis's voice? Orson, I'm
they
shocked.
They were marvelous. You were all three.
Yeah, marvelous.
Absolutely
marvelous.
It's true.
But Kaye, you would have known what a dump, wouldn't you?
I would have said it was from Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I have some advice for both of them not to get in this habit. It's going to wreck their lives.
Oh, no, it won't.
That's my Peter Lorre impression.
Absolutely marvelous.
Even 10% of that kind of wreckage we'll all buy. Believe me. What a joy to have three such talent on our show tonight, and you've graced us more than we can say. And we're terribly grateful. Of course, there was only one incorrect vote. That's worth $250, and you did it.
we just wanted one. Didn't we?
Well, you got it. You got it. And we had one, too. We had one of those nights that we'll never forget. We thank you all for that.
Thank
Good
you.
Night, and God bless you.
And once again, we've reached that very special part of What's My Line, the time we meet our mystery guest. Panel of the Blindfold securely in place.
Yes, Mr.
Yes.
Brown.
Yes.
All right, mystery challenger, would you enter and sign in, please? Panel, our mystery guest has arrived. Remember, please, it's one question at a time. We'll give you 3 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and let's begin the questioning with Mr. Sales.
Oh, this is the first time anybody's called me that in a long time. They call me other things. Dear mystery guest, judging by that wonderful round of reception, you are very well known. Can I assume that you are in show business?
To do that, but I am in show business.
Betty White.
You know, with us sitting together, it's white sales. No, I think. Are you, do you live in New York as opposed to the West Coast?
My heart is in New York, but I live at the West Coast.
Alejandro.
Are you a comedian?
But the answer is indeed yes. Arlene?
If you're not abusing your voice now, do you sing?
Yes.
Beautifully. Soupy.
have you been on a show where you were on television where you were one of the stars?
You mean right now?
Well, the show isn't on right now. It just finished.
Yes, smart aleck.
Betty?
Was it a regular television series?
What?
Was it a regular television series?
For 2 years it was.
Alejandro?
You're beautiful.
You have a marvelous voice. Are you in this moment appearing in any place in New York City?
Arlene?
Do you usually appear in either nightclubs or hotel rooms?
Not if I can help it. Hotel rooms.
Soupy?
As a matter of fact, I've done some of my best performances in hotel rooms.
Soupy?
And that was probably reading the Gideon Bible. It can't be anybody else but wonderful Kaye Ballard.
It is. They're delightful people on this panel. Yes,
they're perfect people.
Yeah. Yeah. What are you doing in New York?
Well, I'm very fortunate because I'm going to be in a David Susskind movie directed by Cy Howard, written by Renee Taylor, Joseph Bologna, called Lovers and Other Strangers.
That was a play, huh?
Yes, yeah. It was a marvelous play.
I must say that I'm delighted you're doing a movie, but I was very sorry your series was canceled because it was
You could
marvelous.
Never be as sorry as I was. No, it's really kind of silly that that show was taken off because at the end of the year it was still in the top 40.
Yeah, but now this means you're going to do some serious singing again.
I hope it means I work.
No, it means, no, Kaye, that's one thing, you know, you have a great voice and you're a great singer and you didn't do that much of it on The Mother's In Law.
Well, the mothers-in-law was such a happy experience for me that I didn't care if I never sang on that.
Yeah, but some of the rest of us care.
Well, thank you. Yeah. Well, yeah, I didn't come here for compliments.
Who's complimenting you? I'm just telling the truth.
Listen, I hear Soupy has a great special coming out.
Thank you.
And Teens is doing well. Oh, Teens White. And oh, you're beautiful, Alice. Oh,
that's Tessie Tidy. That's
No, it's Teens White. And Arlene is more beautiful than ever.
Oh, that's
well,
nice.
You've been doing
Thank
something
you.
With Red Skelton, too, though.
Do you know something? I did a show with Red Skelton, and I must say that sometimes people in show business take people for granted, you know, because I just said, oh, well, Red Skelton. That man is such a genius, he takes my breath away. I mean, I just had forgotten, I think, what a great, great clown he was, and I just like to go on record as saying that he's something special.
You know, Kaye, I think
four score and 7 years ago.
I think I've recalled this before, but yeah. Talk about Red Skelton. You think of him so much as a comedian. And he did a great dramatic job in a movie one time called The Clown, which I saw a number
of
years ago, which was really, really a great movie and a very tender story. But we're always so happy to see you. And
thank you.
Strangers and Other Lovers.
Lovers and Other Strangers. I should mention some of the people in it because they're so spectacular and they're all friends of people on the panel, like Gig Young, Harry Guardino, Bonnie Bedelia, Ann Mira, Cloris Leachman, Ann Jackson, David Burns. I think one of the most brilliant actors named Richard Castellano.
And how can it fail?
Oh, there's so many more. Bob Dishy. Oh, it's
who's
I
in the
can't
picture,
remember all
Kaye?
The
go tell the panel.
Okay.
Kaye, thank you, dear. We'd love to have you. Kaye Ballard. What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word.
Okay, we're back, and it's time now for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. Are your blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, they are.
Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, you have roughly 2 minutes. Fate's law prevails. We'll go one question at a time. We'll start with Arlene Francis.
Thank you. Well, that was a joyous reception. Is it television that you're best known for? It's a bird.
Soupy, are you best known for piping aboard a ship?
Fanny?
Mother. did we establish that it was television? I'm sorry, I can't distinguish the words.
Yes.
Uh-huh. It was television. Do you have your own show? Oh.
Alan?
Are you on Sesame Street? What's
Arlene?
That, maybe?
Sometimes, I guess.
Arlene?
Do you have a show of your own on television? What happened?
Soupy?
No.
Ma'am, is that they don't have a show? Is it a man or a woman we're looking for?
You didn't ask.
Okay. Are you a lady?
Yes.
Fanny?
It's a lady. No. sorry. Are you a comedian?
She better be.
You bet I'm Red Ryder. Alan?
You're a comedian, huh? And you were... You gave a couple of guys here in the front quite a start when you walked in. Would you say that you were known for your physical size? That's
rats.
A yes, I think, huh?
Rats.
Rats?
Not really, Arlene.
You,
15 seconds.
Wait a minute, she hasn't got a show of her own. Are you also in the theater?
Mm-hmm. Soupy?
Are you starring in a big hit on Broadway that just opened and got rave reviews? Are you Kaye Ballard?
Was that that gave you away?
Yeah. Oh, this gave me away.
Oh well.
He recognized it. It's really.
Did you really
remained.
Know it?
Listen, he was terrific, and Fanny both, and Alan gives the greatest parties. Really, absolutely.
Do you like playing Molly O' Indian Maiden?
Yeah. Yes, I've got a run of the play Jew contract. And, no, I'll tell you the truth. It's a wonderful show with absolutely the best cast in the whole world.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the truth.
And heading the cast is Miss Ballard. And
oh, Fanny, yeah. Griffin.
She's so entertaining. She's so marvelous.
Thank you.
Were you intimidated at all? Because you really took on a big bite there and successfully to fill Molly Goldberg's place. It was the one that she was the one who made it all up.
You know something, Larry? I didn't want to do it for 2 years, and then I loved the woman so much that I thought. Yeah, well, I realize there are people that are going to say there is only one Molly Goldberg, and I just, you know, have critics say what they say. I do what I do, and I knew that on opening night I did the best I possibly could do. So
and
that's
you do
a nice
every
feeling.
Other night too,
oh yes.
And your reviews were marvelous, and you deserved them.
No, thank you.
And the other?
I'm gonna accept that. Yes, I did deserve
okay.
it.
Why don't you just because we don't have anything else to do, stay here and
well
talk
I'll play
about,
a little tune.
And we'll talk about the fact that you can eat anything you want to now, and we'll be back with more of What's My
you
Line right
after.
You
don't have to worry about diet.
No.
Is that gorgeous?